So question number 11. An aeroplane leaves an airport and flies due north at a speed of 1000 km per hour. So notice here direction is involved. So let us be very clear about the directions. So north, south, east and west. So there is an aeroplane which flies towards north at 1000 km per hour speed. At the same time, another aeroplane leaves the same airport and flies due west. So another aeroplane, it flies towards west. Let us call the first aeroplane as A, second aeroplane as B, and starting point as S, at a speed of 1200 km per hour. How far apart will be the two planes after 1.5 hours? So this is the distance what we need to find, AB. So after 1.5 hours, A might have travelled a distance of 1000 into 1.5, that is, this is velocity and this is time. Velocity into time is distance travelled. So 1500 kilometers, and B might have travelled 1200 into 1.5 equal to 1800 kilometers. So this is 1800. So AB is nothing but, by Pythagoras theorem, it is square root of A square plus B square. So which is root of 1800 square plus 1500 square. So we could get, we can write this as 18 into 100 square plus, sorry, this is 18 square into 100 square plus 15 square into 100 square. So 100 square is common, so we can take that out. So 100 square to 324, because 18 square is 324 and 15 square is 225. So 100 square, we can take that out of the root and we can write square root of 559. So 100 root 559 is the answer. So question number 12. Two poles of height 6 meter and 11 meter stand on a plain ground. So let us say this is the plain ground. So we have two poles, one is 6 meter and another one is 11 meter. The distance between the feet of the poles is 12 meter. So this distance is 12 meter. We need to find the distance between the tops. So this is the distance what we need to find. So let us call this as A, this as B, C and D. If AD is 12 meter, obviously we can draw an imaginary line here. Let us call this as E. BE is also 12 meter. And notice DE will be 6 meter, because AD and BE are parallel, so obviously AB will be equal to DE, and hence AB is 6 and DE is also 6 meter. The remaining 5 meter we can add it to CE. So 12 and 5, by Pythagoras theorem we will get BC equal to 13 meters. Now question number 13, D and D are points on side CA and CB of triangle ABC, right angle at C. So first let us draw a right angle triangle. So A, B and C, D and D are points on side CA and CB. CA it is D, CB it is E. So let us connect this. We need to prove that AE square. So let us connect AE plus BD square. So let us connect BD Let's draw this as a thick line equal to AB square plus DE square. So first, as we have seen in one of the sums, let us expand LHS. So AE square is equal to CE square plus AC square. This is from the triangle. This is from the triangle ECA, right angle triangle. And BD square is equal to, from triangle BCD, we will get BC square plus CD square. This is LHS. Now for RHS, AB square equal to AC square plus BC square, and DE square equal to, from triangle ECD, CE square plus CD square. So notice, on expanding, we will get all like terms. That is, CE square we have here, AC square we have here, BC square and CD square we have got here. So thus, LHS equal to RHS while expanding. And hence, it is proven. Now, question number 14. The perpendicular from A on side BC of a triangle ABC intersects BC at D, such that DB equal to 3CD. We need to prove 2 times of AB square equal to 2 times of AC square plus BC square. Let us work this out. Let us first expand AB square. Let us take LHS. AB square is equal to AD square plus DB square, which is equal to AD square plus 3CD the whole square, because DB equal to 3CD. So we get AD square plus 9CD square. So far we know only this. Let us go for RHS. RHS 2 times of AC square plus BC square. So we will first find AC square. AC square equal to AD square plus CD square. And BC square is equal to BD plus CD the whole square. Since BD is 3CD, we will get 4CD the whole square, which is equal to 16CD square. Now, RHS is 2 times of AC square plus BC square. So, multiplying this by 2, 2 here, and BC square remains the same. So, we will get 2 times of AC square plus BC square is equal to 2AD square from here, plus 2 times of CD square and 16CD square. So this is 18CD square. Let's call this as 1. Now coming back to LHS, 2 times of AB square. So 2 here, and we are multiplying this by 2 again. So we'll get 2AD square plus 18CD square. So let us call this as 2. Notice that the result 2 is equal to result 1. And hence, 2AB square equal to 2AC square plus BC square is proven.